If you guys are looking for super cheap, fast, and reliable Madden 21 coins, look no further than my sponsor, MuttReserve.com. Coins are currently discounted, guys. They got 24/7 support. They're super awesome to work with. Head on over, use code Poodle for an additional 15% off your order. Hi everybody, it's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, I'm gonna be going over the Madden market, guys. Talk about the lack of content and just kind of how this has affected the market. For all you guys who are still playing pretty strong right now, and still, despite the lack of content, enjoying Madden and having a good time, you guys have probably dealt with the issue of the market. Because the issue right now is specifically with what we're dealing with is that there being no content means you're forced to play with the cards we have now, which is fine. So you got to go buy those cards. Cards are super expensive because no content's driving down. So it's like you can't buy a team right now. You can sell, but then if you sell, you can't play the game. So here's the issue. So I've been thinking about selling my team and getting back a massive haul because of how expensive things are. But the issue is if I sell my team now, I won't have a team, then I don't play Madden. It kind of works out the way. So that's part of the reason why I think people haven't been playing Madden as much potentially because of that. People are selling their teams and now waiting for new content to play again, which is part of the problem. So here's the thing. I'm going to go over the market, kind of go over price with you guys. Open up my Good Morning Madden pack, of course. Nothing there as per usual. Guys, before we get into today's video, make sure you're down below. Hit that subscribe button. Turn that on to my boys. Join the family. Make sure this video a big thumbs up as always. If you guys need coins, pick up some of these players. Or for Team of the Week tomorrow, make sure you head over to MuttReserve.com. Coins are currently discounted. Make sure you use code Poodle for an additional 15% off. Now, start off with the 92 to 93s. Barry Sanders. He was 800K a week and a half ago. He's over a mil. Why'd he go up? Because people just, he's the best card. Nothing's coming out. No reason to not use the best card. His value is actually driven up, which is actually rare for cards to go much up more like that. Here we go. Dan Marino was 220, 199, 210, 270. Junior Seau was 250. Byron Jones was down at 330 to point. Obviously, there's a new legend. Now, Bo's come down only because Bo was crazy expensive to begin with, so you can't really justify. You couldn't justify his Bo price, his price for. He was 700K. He had to come down because he was way over the market value. Now, here's the thing. So, great example here. Let's say you need a quarterback, right? You want a good passing quarterback with above 90 throw power. That's Dan Marino. But Dan Marino, you know, is not worth that. You know, Dan Marino is more like a 190, 220 kind of guy. So, you're not going to buy for that because the issue with buying for that is you buy for 270. Then in a few weeks and something you come out, you sell them. Now you're selling for 190. So you're losing the 70K drop plus the reduction as well. Like, you're getting killed. You're getting killed there. It's as simple as that. That, guys, I really don't recommend buying right now at all. I think it's actually a great time to sell now. Like I said, disclaimer, if you do sell, you really can't enjoy the game right now, which is part of the problem. So if you guys want to be sellers right now and you want to take advantage and make your extra coins, you have to be embraced that. It's gonna be solo battle time and solo challenge time and maybe house rules time. You're not gonna want to touch so much the seasons or the weekend league, and that's part of the problem here. I want to sell. I know that my team's worth about 2.5 million coins, 3 million coins. If I sold them right now, probably getting well over 3 million coins. Easy, even with reduction. But that's the dilemma. If I sell and then this weekend league comes out and we don't have new content and then prices are still up, I get screwed. And that's just the fact of the matter here. So look, McCaffrey, 150K. He was as low as 120 before. Work done was down to 150. Now, of course, some of these cards will stay at their price just because of the training value and stuff. But if you really just look at these, Michael Thomas was 215, 220, I mean, sorry, 115, 120. Now he's almost up to 170K. Who else? Julio's not a great example. The team diamonds have went up as well. JerMichael Finley was down to like 240 to point, back up to 270. Isaiah Simmons, guys, has went up in crazy value, which I'll show you in a second. Here we go, cornerbacks. Because weekend league was, you needed cornerbacks. Playing weekend league all week, I realized that some cornerbacks weren't too great. I realized that my Byron Jones was great, my Nia Williams wasn't as great, so I want to go pick up some new cornerbacks. Ironically, Asante Samuel and company all skyrocketed back up in value, close to 300K. Stephon Gilmore 180, because people just more or less know. And you know what else is funny? When there's lack of content and there's weekend league going on, you notice a few things, guys. You truthfully notice who are the best cards in the game. Like, for example, when Bo first came out, everyone dropped Barry. He went to 800K. Bo was like 700K. People quickly realized in a few competitive games, wow, Barry does not compete with Bo. Barry's way better. So people started to realize that, and I think that's precisely why Barry went back up and Bo actually crashed, because I've been playing with Bo. Bo's great. He's not Barry Sanders. I thought they'd be closer. Bo's actually faster, but he's not Barry Sanders. That agility and change of direction and movement, just right now, in this current state of the game, with the way other defenders can't move, like their lateral quickness and their ability to change direction, Barry just is too quick. He's a little rat. Bo is faster, but straight line. Now, if you guys haven't realized, in Madden, the greatest way to score and the greatest way to make big plays is side-to-side horizontal movement. Stop and goes. It's not straight-line speed. Now, straight-line speed helps, But the thing is, Barry and Bo are here with straight line speed. So what makes the difference is that plus 10 agility, change of direction. And that is exactly why you're seeing the price. Literally, if you want to know what the meta cards are, go check prices of cards. Here's a good example. 87 overall. No one should be above 100K in this category. Isaiah Simmons is going to go for 319,000 coins. He's overpowered, guys. And I'm not going to lie, I'm going to be honest with you guys. He's still worth it. Now, don't pay these prices, of course, despite what I'm saying. Go ahead and sell. Make your coins if you are doing that. But I'm not going to lie, a holy week, a weekend league, Isaiah Simmons was probably the greatest player I've played with. He was amazing. He was phenomenal. His height and his speed and his guy's unbelievable. User pick at least once a game, twice a game, at least four or five pick sixes in my weekend league run. Now, I did get screwed on weekend league. I ran out of time. I couldn't finish my game, which kind of sucked. I had the potential to get up to 17 or 20 wins, considering I ended off, like, I think 13, 14 wins with, like, 7, 8 games remaining. I got kind of screwed. I mean, it was my fault. I didn't time manage properly, and I'm busy with stuff. Kind of busy this weekend. Then football Sunday didn't help, of course. But moving on down more, guys. Let's see the lower overalls, of course, because that's going to be a big difference here, too, because even the lower cards go for a lot. For example, I have a Jason Kelce that I believe goes for, like, 60,000 coins, and that's pretty big because these cards should not go for that much money. So here we go. 86 overall. 85 overall, I believe, actually. Jason Kelce, 75,000 coins for an 85 overall. And why is that? Because people need O-linemen and weekend league to block for their running backs with these great pass rushers. So what they're doing is Jason Kelce is your typical center that's lower in overall, a bit more affordable, and happens to have phenomenal run blocking. Bad pass blocking, but phenomenal run blocking. He's like a budget beast kind of aspect. Not so budgety anymore, but you can see here all the prices on the linemen are up too. It was pretty clear this weekend. Barry was the most coveted running back. Lineman was important, and secondary lineman. Defensive line wasn't too crazy in price, surprisingly, but again, you're noticing it. And then as we get to lower rolls, guys, these don't matter as much because, like I said, these prices don't change too much. Training will either keep them a bit up, a bit down, but their difference is like 3, 4K, 6K. It's more up here where you really notice the big differences, like right up here. But guys, that pretty much wraps up the video and everything I wanted to cover. I just wanted to let you guys know, pretty much, don't be buying stuff. Definitely a great time to sell. If I added up my team, like I said, I'll probably get like 500K to a million coins profit. And that might not sound like a lot. I mean, it definitely is a lot. But that might not sound like a lot when you have to sell a whole entire team. But remember, that's what reduction. So if I have a 3 million coins worth of team, I make an extra 500K, a million coins after I lose the reduction of about 300 or 400K. It's a pretty big haul. Considering you can then take that and then even better, guys. There's always the beauty, right? So team's worth this. You sell it for this. The market crashes to here. You buy a team back here and you keep all of this middle margin gain. But that's pretty much it, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day. Hopefully you guys enjoyed today's video. This will only be the second video of the day, probably the last video, because we don't have a lot of things in Madden right now. I don't want to force out videos for you guys you don't want to see. I want to be able to post things that I feel good about posting, and this is one of them. So hopefully you guys enjoy the rest of your day. If you're into the channel, hit that subscribe button, turn that notification bell, boys. Enjoy the family. Make sure you guys do a big thumbs up as always. That's about it. Enjoy the rest of your day, guys. Make sure to watch Monday Night Football when my Giants do take down the Pittsburgh Steelers. I'm completely lying. They're probably gonna lose, but still gonna be exciting to watch. Gotta rep the Barkley jersey tonight. But guys, about it. Enjoy the rest of the day. I'm out. Peace.